I am a former refugee. Came from Lebanon, but from a Sudanese father and a Saudi mother in the year 2000.
What was it like adjusting to life in a new country?
Definitely was tough, culture shock. You have to start a new beginning. So imagine at age, I mean, luckily I came age of 18. So it wasn't as hard, and I was looking forward to the experience. Nonetheless, there were some barriers, cultural barriers. There were some systemic barriers. This is what actually encouraged me to be part of helping, working for nonprofits or organizations to advocate and support and provide direct services for immigrants or refugees. It started in Utah, Salt Lake City, Utah, and then Oregon, Portland, Oregon, and now I'm in Dubuque, Iowa.
Fantastic. You said you've worked with the Lincoln Center a little bit. Did you work with them at all? I guess you weren't here when you were first into the country, but what kind of work have you done with them?
Well, you mean collaborative work because of my position, I received a service similar to what the presentation Leonard sent her. I'm very familiar with how important it is for the community to have such an organization help communities to. To ease or to facilitate the living in the United States, whether culturally or whether the means to obtain the U.S. citizenship, English language is very important. And when we say English language, we're not talking only verbally, but we're talking about the etiquette and it's extremely, extremely important. And I really like to go every once in a while. I like to go there and hang out remember what it was like. So every time I go there, I meet with the students there and share my experience, and I feel like they could relate and I could. We both are inspired in that process. So
yeah, fantastic. So there's a lot of talk right now about making immigration policy stricter. Mm-hmm. After everything that has happened just in general with this administration that we're under right now, as well as in the wake of what happened with Molly Tibbetts, what's your opinion on this?
Yeah, opinion. I often see throughout the history, the immigration history in the United States, there are often immigrants have to pay the price could be once somebody's fault. Everybody has to pay the price, unfortunately. When you say stricter, can it be any stricter? That's kind of a rhetorical question. It is tough to get a U.S. citizenship. It is tough also to follow the process, and somewhat it's pricey as well. When we're talking about someone who is who believes in the American dream, who believes in, who values what you value, you love your family. They come here to have a security, better secure a place for financial also, for opportunities. Like this is how the founding fathers. I think that this is what the idea of leaving somewhere where it might have been a birth home, but this is a new home that we choose to come to United States. So I think that's the beauty about it. The beauty is recognizing that they value or we value who already have been here in came before us, who they valued human dignity, human rights, liberty, and justice as well. So these are the things that when someone comes here, looks forward to and contributes. contributes, whether economically, culturally, systemically, science. When we come here, not only that we pay taxes, but also we contribute at all aspects and all levels. Ask someone, probably I may not be an expert, but ask someone who was born in the United States, whether European American or African American or anyone who's been here before, when they interact with an immigrant and see the sense of resiliency, a sense of empathy, sense of looking forward to the life and appreciating every moment of it. That's how I look when I think of an immigrant.
When you first came here from your country, did you have an experience of welcoming environment, or was it more of a hostile situation, or how was it?
So generally speaking, it was a very welcoming. I remember the first job was I worked as a bagger 2 weeks from arriving to the United States, and I didn't have English language, per se. I didn't speak English well. So it was fascinating that the cashier or the customer or the manager make sure, you know, whether they give me books to read and see the pictures, or so it felt welcomed, and the families around us, and it might not be for somebody else, but this is just probably back then was my experience was pretty positive and encouraging to look forward to going to school, look forward to having two jobs, two full-time jobs, and going to college to finish college. So even though I learned later on that the race line was not on the same like any other 18-year-old at that time or someone probably older, but I was looking forward to it. It was a challenge. It was, you could tell, it was not, the system or the life was not designed for someone like me to catch up, but nonetheless, I knew I was looking forward. I knew there's something in it for me, and also for to be an American. What it likes to be an American. That's yeah.
What was the hardest part for you when you got here adjusting?
To go and kind of follow up on that first question. Sometimes you have to speak on behalf of the all immigrants, or the stereotype. If I came from Lebanon, if I'm African, if I'm, you know, I'm half Middle Eastern, if something happens in the news, I will be I become the spokesperson all of a sudden. Like, Taj, what do you think of this? And, you know, and I wish they paid me to give him the answer, but I didn't. That's a bad joke, by the way. But so the stereotype and generalization, and I start learning there, when we say an immigrant or a refugee, there's so much, or when someone comes to the United States, so much complexity that people aren't aware of. The 100 questions to learn for a test, so you know, you can learn about history, learn about politics, learn about how government works, learn about your rights and responsibilities. So I think that was the challenge. That's a challenge to be able to live like anyone else, but I still have to do extra to compensate or to just be on a level on somebody else's, you know, any ordinary or anyone around me on their level, if that makes sense.
Yeah. So there's often a lot of scrutiny or intense examination surrounding immigrants in America. What was your opinion on there? How does that make you feel, being someone that has come from a different country?
It is sad. It is sad when I hear about it. And like I mentioned before, when I start reading more and more, watching documentaries and seeing, you know, the Chinese were mistreated, the Chinese American, the Japanese American, now the Latinx or the Hispanic, Arab Americans, always questioned their loyalty to United States. not knowing that we have a very unique identity. You go to Germany to get a citizenship, you become a German. But here you can maintain your culture while being part of, I would like to call it the salad bar, salad bowl instead of a melting pot, that you can still keep your identity.
So this kind of goes a little bit more political, so if you can't answer anything,
sure.
But some politicians have been using Malik Tibbetts' death as a way to promote their political agendas against immigration. Do you see a problem with this, or how does it make you feel knowing that they're doing that?
Well, at the same time, I saw, I forgot the state or the city, that there was someone who committed the same crime, and the news pretty much was that highlighted on, they said, this is a US-born white man who killed and raped someone or raped someone, and they left it that way. And it wasn't as much a reaction. So when a crime happens, regardless who that person is, and I think that's a crime, right? It's a crime. It's not to for anybody else's from the same identity that they have to pay for. It's definitely, like you said, anything could be used now and be politicized and be manipulated. And I think it's you and my homework to, it is unfortunate you see, and it's unfortunate that you see, even though I heard about the person who committed the crime, there was claimed that he might have been mentally ill or has some mental issues. Whether this is an excuse or not an excuse, but could you take that into consideration? You know, is he a lone wolf, or is he, has a mental, or wasn't hugged? If are we gonna put those excuses for him versus for someone else's? So who is excused, who is not excused from committing a terrible crime? And what's even more unfortunate, I hear about that we didn't focus on the victim. We didn't focus on how women have to pay the price to calculate what time they need to go out for a walk, and how they should wear, how they should behave. Why aren't we paying attention? Are we not paying attention to that? So there is more, if I wanted to use an angle, there's so many angles that we could use to shed the light. But again, anyone can use a story and run with it, right? It's an unfortunate. So my responsibility, I know if I had that conversation like I'm having now with you, I would definitely share my opinion and say this is an unfortunate that it's been used that way. But everybody else is also responsible to select, hear, and analyze, read between the lines on news like this. So.
Is there anything else you would say about immigration in the wake of what happened, or just in general?
Well, in general, you know, this is the timing. We're, you know, the family separation. We're in a very interesting timing right now. I wasn't born during the camp that was set out for Japanese Americans because they were questioned by their loyalty. But that's what it feels right now. It feels that's how I feel it. Maybe I'm just living in my own head, but it feels that the give me your tire and all these slogans that we actually came here for, it's either been faded or questioned or reinterpreted, unfortunately. And for who? Who's allowed to come in? Who's not allowed to come in? Now, if you're a Canadian right now, you're European Canadian, white Canadian, would I question that you might be undocumented? Probably not. But if you hear my accent, you probably will ask me, do you have papers? And this is how we're judging, and this is how we're labeling each other, unfortunately. But the work is continuing, and nonetheless, I'm optimistic. There is, when something like this happens, we recognize that we're all affected by it, and eventually we're going to find a better solution that fits all, instead of to accommodate certain community or certain race or certain status in our community. So you're doing a great job. Yeah,
thank you. Yeah, well, thank you very much.
Yeah.